Hello everybody, hope everybody is well and fine. So this is the second part of shift register, where I have designed parallel in parallel out, and then I have designed serial in parallel out. Both the design I have done with D flip flop. So starting with my parallel in parallel out shift register, you can see I have taken 4 D flip flops. I'm talking about 4 bits over here, 4 LEDs are available over here, which is going to show me the output. Okay, and for input I have taken and switches at different points. You can see this is the first input, the second input, the third input, and the fourth input, from where I'll give the data into this D flip flop. And again, as for the first phase, here also I have taken switch in place of clock to show you the movement of data, right? So you can see over here, this is the connections. I have taken 4 different grounds. You can take a single ground also, but if I take that one, it will be more complicated. The design will look cumbersome, so that's why I've taken independent grounds, which will represent 0. Okay, and the input I have taken common, because this look good, a single wire connected, so I have taken from that one. It's up to you. You can take for each individual, or you can take a common one, right? So now let's start the simulation and have a look. So starting the simulation, so you can see it is, everything is 1 now. The first one is 1, this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. So let me change it out. Okay, let me keep the first one as 1, second one as 0, then 1, then 0. Okay, now I'll give the clock pulse. This is parallel in parallel out. My data, input data are available, which is 0, 1, this is 1, 0, 1, 0. There is the data available in the input. So if I give the clock pulse, let me see what exactly is happening. Okay, so my clock is at 0. I'm giving the positive clock pulse now. When the moment I give it, see, you can see the same data is coming out in the parallel, that is 1 0 1 0. I'd given that. Okay, now let me change the clock pulse once again, and let me change the data. Now I'm putting this one as 0, this one as 1, this one is 0, and this one is 1, just the opposite. Okay, so the data is available at the input. The moment I change, it will come as 0 1 0 1. Let us check that. See, 0 1 0 1. So hence I can say my circuit parallel in parallel out shift register is working fine. Okay, now let's move to the next one, that is serial in parallel out. This is a circuit for serial in parallel out, looking a bit complicated. Okay, so that's why I've taken, kept this one as last. So you can see over here, for load and shift I have taken an inverter, and I have taken a switch over here, which will be differentiating between load and shift, where if I take this one as 1, if my switch is at 1, okay, obviously the inverter will pick this one as 0. Okay, so if I put into 0, then my load will take. So load is inverted over here. That means if I take 0, if I put the connection this way, my load is active, data will get into this circuit. And if I put this one into 1, my shifting will take place, right? So you can see the connections I have taken accordingly. You can check the connections over here. Okay, here also same thing, just to reduce the cumbersome over here, I have taken one more ground and sorted it over here. If space is more, you can connect this points to this same ground over here. Okay, nothing confused. I have taken 4 D flip flop representing 4 bit over here. Okay, in place of clock I have taken switch. Okay, you can see I have taken the switch. Okay, this is the one part of the clock, positive trigger, this is the negative trigger of the clock. Okay, and input, same thing, I have taken switch to represent between 1 and 0. So initially this is 0 over here. Okay, and I have connected this part. Okay, so here 2 AND gates I have taken, 1 OR gate, and replicated the circuit. You can see here I have taken this one as 1, this is 1 now, this is also 1. Okay, and this is 0. Okay, now the data is what? 0 1 1 0. This is the data I have kept to over here. I want to load it out. So for load, what I have to give? I have to give 0 over here. So I had given 0. Okay, so when I have given 0, this is 1 now. So from here the data will get loaded. So let me give the clock. So I have given the clock. So my data is loaded now. Okay, so what is the data loaded? That is 0 1 1 0. This is the data loaded. So now let me check it out serially, whether 0110 is coming out over here or not. Let me keep the clock down to 0 and put the shift on. Okay, so I'm putting the switch over here, change to this 1 now. Now I'll put this clock 4 times to see whether I'm getting the same data or not. What I had given, 0110, so I should get 0110. The first clock pulse, was 0, now it is 1 now, because already 0 was there, I got 1. Then the second clock pulse is 1, now I will get 0. Okay, is this clear now? 0 1 1 0, I got it. Okay, so this is how the things are processing in parallel and serial. Parallel data got inside, then serial data got outside. One more example I'll give you over here. Let me change this one to 1 now. Okay, so I have now 0 triple 1. So what I will do is that I'm loading this one and I'm changing this one to clock as 1. So data got loaded. Okay, so now I will shift it out. So you see, I should get 0 triple 1. So already 1 I got it over here. So now with the different clock pulses, I should get all the data. So first one is available. The moment I give the clock, the second one is available. Again, I give the clock, third one is available. Now, if I put clock, 0 is available. So this is how my parallel in shift out or shift register is working. Okay. So this is what I want to explain you over here. Okay. Thank you for watching my video.